Greetings from Team Piping Mantra, and welcome back to a new session where we are going to see an example of calculating MTO. As discussed in earlier sessions, we can recall that MTO can be calculated with two steps. First, calculate all the inline items from the P&ID, and second, calculate pipes and elbows from the 2D layout or from 3D model. So, we will start with the first step, which is calculating all the inline items from P&ID. In this P&ID of hot oil fuel gas knockout drum, where we are going to calculate a line coming from fuel gas distribution P&ID. So, here we have a basic format of MTO in Excel. These may vary from company to company. Before we start, there are some inputs we require, like
P&ID, plot plan,
PMS or piping material specification, and branch table. Here we have a column for area, as we may have different areas, units for defining particular area. Pipe fluid service, unique pipeline number, pipe specification, which defines the material like carbon steel, stainless steel. Here, we will have piping spec from P&ID and insulation thickness of the pipe if line is insulated. Then here, we have component types like valve and its type, flange, plug, nipple, etc. Then we have size 1, 2 and 3. Remember, size 3 is for branch connections like T or reducing T, where we have the third size. Along with size, we have pipe schedule 1, 2 and 3. Wherever we have pressure class for like flange and valve, that can also be written in schedule 1 column. Then we have very important item, which is quantity. Then we have material description, which is taken out from piping material specification. And last we have remark, if any, for any reason. Now let's start. So here we have a section of P&ID where line number is 8 inches dash 122 depicting area, dash 000, which is the unit number, dash GF, which is fluid or service, dash 22004 is the line number, dash 1A3K1, depicting the piping spec, dash 1 inches, which is the insulation, and H is for hot insulation. So, very first fitting would be branch connection for bleed connection, that is socolet here. Size mentioned here is 0.75 inches, so size 1, which is header, would be 8 inch and size 2 would be 0.75 inch. Schedule for header is 40S and schedule for branch connection is 80S and quantity is 1. Next item is nipple for drain, which would be connected in between ball valve and socolet of 3 inch or 4 inch. Normally here we will consider 3 inch nipple. Spec will be the same and it's a fitting size 1 and 2 would be 0.75 inch and schedule would be 80S and quantity would be 1. Next item would be valve, so in component it would be valve and its type we can see from symbol is ball valve. Its size would be 0.75 inch and pressure rating would be 800 pound as we have valve pressure rating, not the schedule, and its quantity is 1.
Ball valve with one side threaded and one side socket weld ended.
Next is plug of schedule 40SS and quantity is 1. Next is flow elements, which you can see in red markup. So here we will have two orifice flanges of 8 inch and 300 pound.
In some companies, orifice flanges will be brought by instrumentation department.
Then we have two tappings for pressure of 0.5 inches. So it would have two nipples of 3 inch. Two ball valve of 800 pound. Then we have two 3-inch length nipples connected to pressure tapping, which comes under instrument department.
As I said, quantity is 2, so we will copy these items again.
Then we have one inline ball valve and it is welded, so there will be no flanges. Here you can see we have 2-inch bypass connection. So for branch connection, we have weld outlet of 8-inch to 2-inch, both of the pipe having same schedule thickness, that is 40S schedule. Then we have 2-inch ball valve and we have drain connection. So here we will copy the above bleed assembly and change the header size from 8 to 2. After this bleed, we have globe valve. Just to remind you again, all these valves of 2-inch and above are welded. Then we have this bypass, which is again connected to header. So here we have considered 8x2-inch weld outlet. Moving back to header, the very first item is drain connection. So we will copy all the items from above. Then we have PDT connection, for which we have to consider a branch connection, that is a socolet. A nipple and a ball valve. Remember, after ball valve, there will be scope of instrument department. Here we have SDV, which is the emergency shutdown valve. Here we can see its size mentioned as 8-inch and we will consider it as flanged valve. So we consider two 300-pound flanges for SDV. Since SDV is under instrument department scope, we will not consider it in our MTO. Moving back to header, the very first item is drain connection. So we will copy all the items from above. Now again, we have PDT connections, so we will copy all its items from above.
Now we have check valve of 300-pound. This particular valve is not welded, so we will consider two flanges here.
Then we have standby control valve connection. You can see on your screen that we have two duplicate control valve assemblies. Now moving forward, we have branch connection of 8x8, which will be equality of 8-inch. Here we have to mention all three sizes and their schedules. Next is ball valve. Then again we have drain connection. We will copy it from above. Then we have reducer. Remember, second size is not mentioned, so as per thumb rule, we assumed a one size smaller reducer. As we know, there are two types of reducer, eccentric and concentric. Here, we will consider eccentric reducer to match the bottom of pipe. Remember, we can use concentric, but it's a general practice we use eccentric reducer here. So its size would be 8x6 inches and schedule will be same for both the pipes. After reducer, we have flow control valve, which is flanged valve. So we considered two 300-pound flanges. And control valve will be considered by instrument department. Then again, we have reducer with size ID not mentioned. But since we already assumed the upstream size, we will know it would be 8x6 eccentric reducer. After this, we have drain connection, which we would copy from above. And then we have ball valve. Now from this ball valve 22159 to ball valve 22394 is same in main line. So we can copy all this as all the assembly is same. After that, we have closeout branch connection, which would be equality, right? So now moving in the P&ID, you can see we have break here, that is the insulation break. H stands for hot insulation, whereas HET stands for hot insulation with electrical tracing. This break is at branch connection whose size is 6 inches. So we are going to use reducing T as per PMA branch connection table. So in component type, it would be reducing T. Size 1 would be 8 inch and size 2 would be 6 inches. And as we know, schedule would be 40S for both the pipes. Moving forward, here we will consider reducing T for 4 inch branch. We have tie-in for future connection, which is written here in note 6, which you can see on your screens. So remember, P&ID nodes are also important while calculating MTO, as this will impact line routing for layout. Then we have ball valve, so we have added it in our Excel. Then we have blind connection. So first we will add weld neck flange of 4 inches here so that blind flange can be connected. Then we have spectacle blind connected with equipment nozzle. So here we will have one flange and one spectacle blind, both of 300 pound. Now, these are all the inline items which we can calculate based on P&ID. Now, for piping and elbow, we need either 2D layout or 3D model. Nowadays, when we use 3D modeling software like E3D, S3D or Plant3D, these can directly fetch what you put in 3D model. So, correct 3D model is necessary for correct MTO. Manual MTO is normally required at the early stage of the project, and we do not have time to model all the inline items in 3D, so only piping and elbows can be calculated with either basic 2D layout, or best way is to route in 3D model. So from 3D model, this is the outcome. 8 inch pipe is almost 37 meters. 8 inch elbows are 8 in numbers. 8 inch 45 degree elbows are 2 in number. 2 inch pipe is 9 meters. And 2 90 degree elbows of size 2 inches are used. We have 200 mm 4 inch pipe, 600 mm of 6 inch pipe where insulation is H, and 400 mm of 6 inch pipe where insulation is HET. So that is it, guys. If you have any comments or doubts, please write it down in the comment section. So see you next time. Take care. Bye bye.